Hi friends, in this particular video I am giving you a brief idea about flag register, okay, and how flags are affecting if you perform any arithmetic or logical operation, and I will give you with help of numerical problem. Let us see. So in last presentation I am indicating what are the various flags, okay, and what is the overview of our flag register. Let us look it into once. Okay, so you know already this is your flag register, and size of flag register is 16 bit, that is from D0 to D15. So out of 16 bit some are reserved flags, so 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, so 7 are reserved flags, so remaining only 9 are the effective flags. So in these 9 also 6 are general flags and 3 are processor control flags. See here pin number 8 9 10, these 3 are called as processor control flags. So the flags are TF means trap flag, interrupt flag and direction flag. These 3 are processor control flags, and general flags are mainly carry flag, priority flag, auxiliary carry flag, zero flag, sign flag and overflow flag. Let us see how these flags are affecting if you perform addition of two numbers. See here. See here, now I already mentioned that TS, IF and DF means trap flag, interrupt flag and direction flag. These 3 are processor control flags. So these flags are not affecting if you perform any arithmetic or logical operation. And these flags are mainly control the processor. Let's say if it is a direction flag, it will control the execution direction of the processor. Trap flag indicates if it is 1, then automatically processor will enter into single step mode. Like that, I was already given description of each one. IF is interrupt flag. If it is 1, then only processor will recognize the external interrupts. Okay, these 3 are processor control flags. Now coming to our main general flags. See here, carry flag, auxiliary carry flag, zero flag, sign flag, priority flag and overflow flag. These 6 are called as general flags. If you perform any arithmetic or any logical operations, nothing but any ALU operations, only these 6 are affecting. Let us see in which way they are affecting. For example, my aim is I need to add 2 8-bit numbers and identifying affecting flags. For example, in these 2 8-bit numbers are, one is 75H and other is 39H. First step is I'm converting the 75H decimal into the hexa number into equivalent binary number. So 75 hexa. So you know every hexa number is equivalent to 4 binary. So 7 equivalent binary is 0111. 5 equivalent binary 010. Similarly, 39 equivalent binary 0011. 9 is 1001. If we perform addition, so 1 plus 1 is result is 0, but we have carry. So carry will move to, actually this is D0 bit and this is actually D7. D0 to D7. This is D3, D4, D5, D6 and D7. See here, D0 bit of first number added to D0 bit of second number, we get result. So in this particular case, 1 plus 1 is result is 0, but we have carry. Now this carry is present in D1 bit. So 0 plus 0 plus 1 is result is 0, no carry. 1 plus 0 is 1, similarly 0 plus 1 is 1. So 11 is 10, 111 is 11. So we have result 1 and carry 1. So 11 is again 10, and last D7 bit is 0 plus 0 plus 1 is 1. So if you add 75H with 39H, your result is 1010, similarly 1110. So equivalent XA is AEH. So 75H added with 39H, result is AEH. So this is overall result of adding. So based on this result, we can say that which flags are affecting. First coming to carry flag. So when carry flag is 1, carry flag is 1, when there is a carry out of MSB bit, means after D7, if any carry appeared, then only carry flag is 1. So here flag is affecting after D7, so no carry out of MSB bit. So for this particular case, carry flag is 0 because no flag is occurred after D7. Then auxiliary carry flag. Auxiliary carry flag is set to 1 when there is a carry moved from D3 to D4. So D3, during D3 addition, if any carry comes from D3 to D4, then only auxiliary carry occurred. So in this particular addition, no carry is moved from D3 to D4. So auxiliary carry flag also 0, so it is not affecting. So coming to zero flag. So if result contains all zeros, then only zero flag is affecting. But here result contains AEH, it's not 00. So zero flag is also 0. Then other is a sign flag. So sign flag must be 1 if MSB bit is 1. So in the result of MSBPT is 1. So sine flag is 1. And the so sine flag is 1. And the overall result is now it's a negative number because the MSBPT is 1. It indicates that overall result is negative. Then coming to priority flag. So I already mentioned priority flag is 1 when result contains even number of ones. If you see result including carry also. So, but here no carry. So total result contains even number of ones. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we have 5 ones only. So it's not even number, odd number. So that's why parity flag is not affecting. So 0. Coming to overflow flag. So overflow flag is very important. Overflow flag is set to 1 when there is a carry into MSB bit and no carry out of MSB bit. So carry into MSB, no carry out of MSB. So it is true. Sometimes if there is a no carry into MSB and carry out of MSB, in that case also 1. So first condition is satisfying. The first condition carry into MSB and no carry out of MSB. So carry into MSB bit is available, no carry out of MSB. So no carry out of MSB. So both statements are satisfying. That's why overflow flag is 1. Like that we can identify which flags are affecting. Okay. So thank you for watching. Okay, so if you satisfy this particular video, please kindly share and subscribe my channel.